Here's what you need to know. If Thursday night screenings are any indication, it's going to be a very interesting weekend at the box office. There are three new picks out this week, and they're all aiming for a very different crowd. As Deadline's Anita Bush reports, The Purge Anarchy grabbed 2.6 million in late night screenings starting at 8 p.m. in 2,194 theaters. That's $800,000 less than the first Purge made on its July opening weekend last year. But when the real horror and scream crowd hit the theaters tonight, we could see a Purge surge. Sony's R-rated comedy Sex Tape pulled in 1.1 million in its Thursday screenings in 2,457 theaters starting at 7 p.m.
Yes!
While Disney animated sequel Planes, Fire and Rescue was basically even with the first flick, with about 450,000 pulled in last night. Of course, family fare rarely soars in Thursday evening screenings, so wait until Saturday for the jets to kick in on this one. With all that, it looks like Dawn of the Planet of the Apes will hold the top spot again this weekend. Heading into its second weekend, the Fox-distributed pick celebrated a milestone yesterday as it crossed the 100 million mark domestically. Dawn has now made 102.9 million as of this morning. Speaking of Fox, who is the media mogul who loves to drop news via social media? Well, that would be Rupert Murdoch. As Deadline's David Lieberman reports, just days after Time Warner's rejection of his 20th Century Fox's $80 billion bid for the company, Murdoch was back on Twitter after a week and a bit break to announce with understatement that A, he's been busy with many preoccupations, and B, he was sorry, but he couldn't buy either the Tribune Group or the LA Times because of what he called cross-ownership laws for another age. Of course, the Tweety mogul took a very different social media stance a few hours after that when he announced that he was relaxing at last in the Australian bush, hoping he could see some kangaroos later. Yesterday saw the tragic downing of a Malaysian Airlines plane over the Ukraine and the death of all on board. As Deadline's Jen Yamato reported, Thursday also saw a death in the Hollywood community addressed by those who were being held responsible. Less than a week after surrendering to Georgia authorities on involuntary manslaughter and criminal trespassing charges related to the February 20th death of camera assistant Sarah Jones, Midnight Rider director and producer Randall Miller and Jody Severin called the train tracks fatality a horrible tragedy and a horrific accident. Thursday also saw the executive producer and unit production manager of the now shuttered Greg Allman biopic, Jay Sederich, turn himself in on the charges too. He was released after posting a $27,700 bond. Also, Miller and Severin waived an arraignment hearing yesterday and pled not guilty to the charges. While Sederich has not entered a plea yet, he is widely expected to also plead not guilty. The next step will be the setting of a pretrial date as the long process of justice in this case moves forward. Keep checking back for more video news from the Deadline team. I'm Dominic Patton for Deadline Hollywood.